Hello students, today we will learn sum of n terms of an AP. Listen here. The mathematician Gauss applied a method for finding out the sum of first 100 positive integers. How he done the magic, you see. First 1 to 100 terms the sum found out within short seconds. How he found out, you just see the method I will explain and give you. Here S means what? Sum. S is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. 100. And then he taken S reverse. See here, from here onwards. 100, 99, 98, 97, etc. 1. Okay. So first he taken in the order. And then he taken the reverse order. Okay. 199. So now we are going to add it. Here you see, adding it. S plus S, what it will come to? S. 100, 1 plus 100. 101. 99 plus 2. For your understanding, I kept in this way. 99 plus 2. 101. 98 plus 3. 101 plus etc. 100 plus 1. How much coming? 101. Actually, this 101, how many times came? 100 times written. This is separate, I reckon. 100 times came. 101, how many times? So, here you see 1 to 100, no? So, in this way, adding also, how many times will come? 100 times will come. Okay, that is equal to 2s is equal to 100 times 101. How many times came? 100 times 101 came. Okay, clear? And then what is S got? S is equal to 100 into 101 divided by 2, 100 by 250, and 50 into 101, 5050. So he found out the answer within a short second. If you are doing in this way, 1, 2, 3, etc., adding and finding out the 100 terms sum, it will take you more time. Maybe it will take you half day also. Okay, but this he done in a technical way. First he done in the correct order, then he reversed the numbers, then he added up and down, added, and how many times added, how many terms was here? Total 101. How many times came? 100 times. This is not multiply here, I simply here written how many times came only written. So 2s is equal to how much? 100 times 101. So that 100 by 2 into 101. From this one, how derived the formula, I will show here. So from this term, how it is derived, formula we derived, you see here. This 2s is equal to 100 into 101. So I split it is. 2s is equal to 100 into this 101, I split it as 1 plus 100. Is it clear? And this 2 I divided here, 100 by 2. Okay. And this 1 plus 100. And 100 means how many terms was there? N terms. 100 terms was there, no? So number of terms. 100 means how many terms was there? 100 terms were there. So N. In the place of 100, what I written? N. N by 2. Into. What is a 1 in the sum? 1 to 100 taking. What is this 1? 1 is the first term. That is I written A here. And what is this 100? 100 was the last term. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. 100 came, no? So this 1 is the first term and this 100 is the last term. So you got the formula. S is equal to N by 2 into A plus L. So from this one we can derive one more formula. What is the formula here? See here. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus a here as it is I written. And what is the value of L? L means last term, a plus n minus 1 into d. What is an? L means last term, or we can say as an. So what is the formula for an? We have studied in the previous videos. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So this A and this A adding together, you will get 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So these are the two formula. First formula is this one. S is equal to n by 2 into a plus l. So s is equal to n by 2 into first term plus last term. This one we are using for finite AP. Finite AP means finite number of terms are there in the AP then. Okay. And this one we are using for infinite AP. Actually this one we can use for infinite AP and finite AP both. Okay. It depends upon you. We can here sometimes we can able to find out the last term and otherwise we can able to apply the formula direct any way you do. So I want to get the only the answers. Okay. And this is the mathematician goes derived the formula in this way. Okay. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l. So who derived the formula also can able to ask for the examination. The mathematician goes is derived the formula for Sn. Okay. And now another method also I shown here. Another method, this is also it is there in the textbook. Another method you see. S. So very clearly you know in first term what we are writing a. Second term what is the formula? A plus 1d or a plus d. And third term a plus 2d. Is it clear? And nth term a plus n minus 1 into d. Same way. Reverse it. Reverse the term. Nth term right here. Okay. A plus n minus 1 into d. What is the formula for nth term? A plus n minus 1 into d. Next term. A plus n minus 2 into d. Next term. A plus n minus 3 into d etc. Then a. Clear? First this term you write in the order. All of you knowing this one. First term plus second term plus third term etc. A plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. And reverse the terms. Reverse the terms. Then you will get a plus n minus 1 into d plus n minus. Okay, here s is equal to first term plus second term plus third term plus this one. And here reverse then written here. Now we will calculate. Same method only. Here instead of numbers, symbols are there. That only the difference. So s plus s. How what will come to s? Now you see here, this adding properly think and add. A, this term and this term adding. So what is a plus a, what will come to a? Plus n minus 1 into d. Clear? And this one you add. So this one adding, I shown in the last page, you can see. I just given for your understanding. Here I written here. See here. A plus d, a plus n minus 2 into d. How adding you see? A plus a to a, n minus 2, okay, n minus 2, and here 1d coming, no, so n minus 2 plus 1, so n minus 2 plus 1, how much coming, n minus 1 into d, okay, 2a plus n minus 1 into d, this is not need to write in your notebook, this is for your understanding calculation, simply I shown here, so this that is why I written in the bracket, no need to write, some students are not understanding how it is added. So that I written here. So in this way added a plus a to a coming. Then d how many times? Here n minus 2 times coming. Here 1 time coming. So we taken together. N minus 2 plus 1. So how much coming? N minus 1. Clear? That now we can go there. See that. So this term adding what you are getting? 2a plus n minus 1 into d. And these two adding how you are getting? 2a plus n minus 1 into d. And the last term added a plus a 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this 2a plus n minus 1 into d how many times came? N times came. Because this is how many terms are there? N terms are there. The previous we have taken now 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 100. So how many times there came? 100 terms. Same way this is the first term, second term, third term and this is the nth term. The meaning is that when adding also how many terms you will get a total n terms will get. That I written as here 2a plus n minus 1 into d. How many times added? N times added. Is it clear? So n times we are adding. So that is why I written here 2s is equal to n times 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay. Now, see here, therefore, what is the formula for s? S is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Clear? So, now, repeat the formula. We can say all the formulas once more. The formulas are, first one, s is equal to n by 2 into a plus l. This is for finite AP. And s is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. And this is used for infinite AP. Is it clear for you now? So once more, you can see the previous calculation. Once more, you go through the points, you yourself write. See, anywhere doubt is there, you can able to clear. Clear now? Here is first term, second term, third term, and nth term. Here what we done second is reversed. So previous method you understood now. So same method only, here symbols using. So reverse it. A plus n minus 1 into d. And here a plus n minus 2 into d etc. plus a. And adding also. You were searching. Okay. So how many times 2a plus n minus 1 into d coming? How many times coming? N times coming. Okay, why n times coming? This is first term, this is second term, this is third term, this is what term? Nth term. So n, how many times the adding will come? This 2a minus 2a plus n minus 1 into d, how many times added? Here one time, here two time, three time, four time, etc. up to how many times came? N times came. Therefore, I written here n. Okay? Therefore, s is equal to what will come? N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Formulas again same. That's the formula for Sn. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l, or Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Clear? These formulas are very important. Now I will, this chapter totally, this video mostly most of the formulas only. Okay, remaining formulas see. Sum of first n natural numbers. Sum of first n natural numbers. Okay. Sum of first n natural numbers. What is this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Natural numbers means you knowing that 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So what's the value of A? 1. And what's the common difference? See here. Okay. So, first term is 1 and common difference also 1. So, direct apply in our formula. These are very, very important formulas. So, formula apply here. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. In the place of a, we are applying the value of a. What's the value of a? 1. And what's the value of d? 1. Okay. Simple calculation only, but the formulas are very important. 2 n plus n minus 1. So this plus 2 and minus 1, how much will come? Plus 1. So what you got? N by 2 into n plus 1. So what is the formula for sum of n natural numbers? What is the formula for sum of n natural numbers? N into n plus 1 divided by 2. The formula for sum of first n natural numbers is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. Clear? Again saying, the formula for sum of n natural numbers is equal to what will come? N into n plus 1 by 2. Okay. And now same method, we will find out sum of n even numbers and sum of n odd numbers. Here see, sum of even numbers, n even numbers. So first I written even numbers. And what's the value of A? 2. And what's the value of D? He also you got 2. Okay. So in the formula, what is the formula for Sn? N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into D. In the place of A, you apply the value of A. In the place of D, you apply the value of D. Applied A. So n by 2 into 2 into 2, how much coming? 4. Now open this bracket. Open the bracket. 2n minus 2. So plus 4 minus 2, how much term become plus 2. So n by 2 into 2n plus 2. Now you can take 2 common now here from this term, you can take 2 common outside, 2 common take it is. So 2 I taken common here. So what you got the answer? This 2 and this 2 will cancel. Up and down again, no. So it will cancel. So what is the formula for Sn? Sum of n even numbers. Sum of n even numbers, what will come? N into n plus 1. What is the sum of n natural numbers? N into n plus 1 by 2. Just above you had done. See here. Sum of n natural numbers, what will come? N into n plus 1 by 2. And sum of n even numbers, what will come? N into n plus 1. Clear? Very, very important formulas, this all. Okay. Now students, you see, next formula, third formula, okay. I told you already, this video full formula only, okay. Sum of n odd numbers, that is also we are doing by the same method. First you write the odd numbers and the value of a is 1 and value of d you know in common difference you got 2 and apply in the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d is your formula. So in the place of a we will apply the value of a 1 and in the place of d you apply the value of d as 2. So n by 2 into 2 into 1 2 plus 2n minus 2. See here only simplifications. Concept you want to get me. So n by 2 into this plus 2 and minus 2 cancelled, you will get 2n. So this 2 and 2 up and down cancel. So what you will get the answer? N into n, n square. So what you got? Sn is equal to n square. So this is the sum of n odd numbers. So I explained here, sum of n odd numbers explained, sum of n natural numbers explained, sum of n even numbers also explained. These formulas all are important. Okay? Clear? Copy it by you. Now see the next formulas. I written here one formula. An is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Actually this is a formula. I simply shown an example for you, for your understanding. See here. S3. S3 means what? Sum of three, first three terms. 1 plus 2 plus 3. How much got? 6. And S4 how much got? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. How much got? 10. Now you just subtract S4 minus S3, subtract and see. 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6 how much got? 4. What is 4? 4th term. See here. 4 is the 4th term. So the formula clear now. A4 is equal to S4 minus S3. Same way. An is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Actually S4 means you see 1, 2, 3, 4, this much adding you are getting no S4. And S3 from where to where will come? Up to here S3 will come, no. So that this A4 how will get A4 is equal to S4 minus S3. Are you got the formula? So what is the formula for An? An is equal to some MCQs we will apply the formulas. Sometimes in some verbal questions also we will apply this formula. So what is the formula for an? An is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Okay. So therefore what you can say here, I written A4 is equal to S4 minus S3. And then what will be A6? S6 minus S5. Okay. Then what will be A7? S7 minus S6. Clear? Okay, clear now. What's the formula? Once more see, An is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Okay? So, for making clear, I given these examples. It is not necessary to write only formula writing in the notebook. Okay. Clear? Okay. Now, the next formula D. This is also one extra formula is there. So, how much extra formulas knowing that much good. So, D is equal to AM minus AM divided by M minus M. So, it's a justification I written here. Actually, it is not necessary for you. how what he wants to know, that is why I written here. Formula is this much only. What is the formula? Common difference d. Another formula is that this one, am minus an divided by m minus n. So what is am? Am means mth term. So how we'll write it? A plus m minus 1 into d minus, what is nth term formula? A plus n minus 1 into d. Now open the bracket. Here opening the bracket, this minus will go inside. Minus a minus of this term. So plus a minus a will cancel, and open here the bracket, m into d m d minus 1 into d d minus d. Okay, then put the minus inside, minus n into d minus n d, and here minus, so plus 1, plus 1 into d d. So this minus d plus d will cancel, so you will get m d minus n d. So we can take common. What is common? D common into m minus n. Therefore, what is the formula for d? Now divide here, a m minus a n divided by m minus n. Okay. So what is the another formula for d? D is equal to, you already studied d formula. What is the formula of d? A2 minus a1 or a3 minus a2 or a4 minus a3. But some typical cases, this formula also application will come. So by Hutton key. So what is the formula for d? Am minus an divided by m minus n. Okay. Now this formula, it is given in your summary part in the textbook. Summary part of this formula also given. If a b c are three consecutive terms of the AP, for example 1 2 3 1 2 3 are the three consecutive terms of an AP, then 2 2, how you will get a 1 plus 3 divided by 2. So this b we are calling as arithmetic mean of a and c. This is the word meaning. So if a b c are any three consecutive terms of the AP, any AP you take, in any AP you take any three consecutive terms, that is continuous terms take, not a break, 1 2 3 2 4 6 8 etc., continuous terms take. So if a b c are three consecutive terms of the AP, then what we will call this b? This b is called a arithmetic mean of a and c. That means the value of b, how you will get a plus c divided by 2, and this b is called the arithmetic mean of a and c. Okay, got clear? You can take any examples, you take and see. I give a best example, 1 2 3 consecutive terms, no? So 2, how you will get a 2 is equal to 1 plus 3 divided by 2. Okay, clear? Okay, formula section full complete. Okay, now we will start to do the exercise. Okay, formulas, all of you revise once more. Revise the formulas. So I given many formulas, 6 formulas given. 6 plus 2 8 formulas given. So sum of n terms 2 formulas, finite AP and infinite AP 2 formulas given. Okay, then sum of n natural numbers formula given, sum of n odd numbers formula given, sum of n even numbers formula given, and another formula, an is equal to sn minus sn minus 1 formula given, and this is next formula d, am minus an divided by m minus n formula given, and what is the meaning of arithmetic mean, this formula also given. Clear? So now we can move to the exercise now. Okay, clear? Formula by heart and come tomorrow. Okay. Question, listen. Exercise 5.3. Find the sum of the following AP. Find the sum of the following AP. So you want to find out sum. See, nth term asking, you have to find out an. Sum asking, you have to find out sn. Not to confuse in between. Any questions nth term asking. So number of terms means the meaning is that n. So fifth term finding out, which formula will apply? An. Sum of fifth five terms asking sn. So not to confuse in between. Sum and number of terms and nth terms, all are different questions. Which term, the meaning is that n. And find out the fifth term, that means n, and sum of n terms, the meaning is that Sn formula. Clear? Here we want, what we want to find out, find the sum of the following AP. So 2, 7, 12, etc. to 10 terms. Very clear here. First you make a clear question. But you want to find out sum. So here, what is the first term? A is equal to 2. And what is the common difference? D? A2 minus A1. 7 minus 2, 5. How many terms sum you want to find out? N terms. N how many? 10. How many terms? N terms. That means n is equal to how much will come? 10. So here what you want to find out? Sum. So which formula will apply? Sn formula. Okay. See. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Clear? So S10. In the place of n we will write 10. S10 is equal to 10 by 2 into, in the place of A, you apply the value of A, and in the place of D, you apply the value of D. So 2 in 10 by 2 means 5, 2 into 2, 4, okay, 9 into 5. So these are all calculations only. Calculate. 9 into 5, 45, plus 4, 49. 49 into 5, how much coming? 245. Did you found out the sum? Yes. Sum of 10 terms is equal to, sum of 10 terms is equal to how much got? 245. I got clear, this is only the, all the sum same method. Sum of 10 terms is equal to how much got? 245. So now I given question number 2 and question number 3 are homework. Okay. Now the last sum. Okay. Okay, now the last two questions. 1 by 15, 1 by 12, 1 by 10, etc. to 11 terms. Method is same calculation you want to see little properly. What is the first term? A. How much got 1 by 15? And what is the common difference? D. A2 minus A1. That means 1 by 12 minus 1 by 15. So find out the LCM of 12 and 15. How much coming? 60. So 60 divided by 12, how much coming? 5. And 60 divided by 15, 4 coming. So 5 minus 4, 1. So the value of D is 1 by 60. What's the value of D? 1 by 60. Okay. Now, how many terms are sum you want to find out? 11 terms. So what is I written here? N is equal to how much? 11. So all the necessary things you got now. First term got, common difference got, and number of terms also got. So apply the formula. Calculate along with me. You take a notebook and calculate. Therefore, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So S11 is equal to 11 by 2 into 2 into value of A, how much coming? 1 by 15 plus 11 minus 1 into 1 by 60. So 11 by 2 into only calculations, again I am saying. So 2 by 15, 2 into 1 by 15, how will you write it? 2 by 15, 11 minus 1, 10, 10 into 1 by 60. So up and down 0 will cancel. So what will write? Get 11 by 2 into 2 by 15 plus this 1 and here 6. 1 by 6. Okay students. Now take LCM. 11 by 2 into, what is LCM of 15 and 6? How much coming? 30. So 30 divided by 15. How much will come? 2. 2 into 2. 4 I written here. Plus 30 divided by 6, 5 coming, 5 into 1, 5, okay. So 11 by 2 into 9 by 30, okay, calculate by yourself. So 11 by 2 into, here up and down 3 will cancel. So what will come here? 3 by 10, 11 into 3, 33. 2 into 10, 20. So you got sum of 11 terms. What is the sum of 11 terms? 33/20. Okay, sum of 11 terms is equal to 33/20. Copy this also. While coming for the next day for the classes, properly all the formulas learn and come. So several times you read the formulas, then only you will get the formula easy. Okay, bye. Tomorrow we will see.